Okay, this is a collection of Ventures records, just kind of odds and ends, different ones that I have, and that I haven't included in the other videos. And this first one is Walk Don't Run. I actually have put several copies of this in another video or two, but variations of it. This is a variation I've never seen before. This is the only copy I've ever seen this way. In 35 years of collecting records, and Ventures records in particular. And what's different about this one is this banner up here, this wide banner at the top, and that the English copies, this is a U.S. copy, but the English copies have a banner. It's about half that width that they put at the top of their Ventures records. You know, I guess Liberty Records or whatever the label was for them. This one, it has the usual back cover. Everything else is pretty much the same, except for that banner on the front. Although I should say that down here it doesn't give any of the manufacturing information. It doesn't say Seattle, Washington here. Usually they say something else about where it was manufactured, and I did look at the matrix number. It was made by Columbia. It was pressed by Columbia Records in Hollywood, their Hollywood pressing plant. Now they pressed a lot of other labels like Dalton and even Capitol and all these labels that were pressed actually at the Columbia Records. I'm holding on to this. I see the C right here, and I think what that means on this copy is that it was a record club issue, and that's why it's not saying anything specific about manufacturing, where it was done, who did it, any of that, like some of the other copies of the Walk Don't Run album do. So anyway, that I thought was interesting. The next one is, this is the only time that I'll just leave it back here. It's the only time. This is a Japanese copy of the Bobby V. Meets the Ventures album, and it's a good record. But it was only pressed in Japan once on LP that I know of, and this is the only. This copy is it, and this was in the early '70s. It says Pops, American Pops Graffiti on that Obi strip at the top, and. So that's kind of interesting. Apparently, this album wasn't big, and you know, because the Japanese would press, repress Ventures LPs quite often. Here's the Telstar album, a Japanese copy, and this is also, I'll say, it's the only time that it was. It's the first time, not the only time. The first time. It wasn't until the early 70s. This was an album that came out in, I believe, 61, 62, and was very big in the U.S. But in Japan, they only released a little 10-song version of it back in the 60s. They didn't get around to releasing a full, complete version of it that had all the original songs until the early 70s. And it has the original U.S. album cover here, the domestic styled cover. I think the back is different than what we had in the U.S. But, I just find that somewhat interesting. It was such a big album. They did put a lot of the songs on other, albums, LPs, but that complete album, that was the first time in the early 70s. Here's the Ventures Batman theme, very different cover than what we see in the U.S. This is a Japanese issue on red vinyl, and they feature three of the songs on the front cover: Batman theme and 007-11, Adventures original, a great one, and Secret Agent Man, which was a bit of a hit for the Ventures, and there it has this wonderful back cover of the Ventures down below there, standing in front of a billboard for 007 Thunderball, James Bond movie Thunderball. I was going to say something, it wasn't quite right about that. But, okay, so here we are, Flights of Fantasy. this is the only time this album was ever released in Japan as an LP. It was released in a CD, on a CD many times after this, but or a few times anyway. But this is a red vinyl Japanese copy in beautiful condition. I didn't have it earlier on the video that where I went through the Japanese albums from the 60s. So I was glad to finally find a copy. And it took a long time to find this one. I didn't find it on eBay. You can find a lot on eBay. And I finally just did a general search on the internet, and I found it. Somebody with just a private collector with a private collection. So sometimes that's what you got to do. So the back cover is a bunch of Japanese writing, but I've got the album in a separate sleeve just to take care of it because it's in such great condition. Here is a Japanese version of the Hawaii Five-0 album, although I think they've switched one of the tunes on it for another tune that wasn't on the domestic version of the Hawaii Five-0 album. And you see this title, Golden Greats, on here. Originally they were in the U.S. going to release an album called, Golden Greats or More Golden Greats. And then this Hawaii Five-0 song hit. And so they changed, they changed their mind in the U.S. and put out the Hawaii Five-0 album. Well, apparently the signals got crossed and they didn't know. They've got this extra title, Golden Greats, and then Hawaii Five-0 on the Japanese issue. It's the only LP issue of Hawaii Five-0 of that album in Japan. And I find that interesting because, most Ventures LPs were pressed repressed a number of times, have given different covers and variations. This one, for some reason, on LP, was only released this in this form in Japan. And again, it was released on CD, once or twice. Here is just the domestic version, and I thought I'd show that. Oh, I didn't show the back cover of this one. It had a nice picture of the Ventures with Jerry McGee on the left there. Okay, here's a Japanese version of an album called Golden Greats, or More Golden Greats, I should say. That one was called Golden Greats, this is called More Golden Greats. And, the Japanese call it the Ventures Deluxe Volume 2. We did, in the U.S., it had the same cover, but it didn't have that Ventures Deluxe Volume 2 on it. This album is a good record. It's got some songs that, it is largely a compilation, but there's a few songs that are unique to this album that first appeared on that album. Swamp Rock by a Japanese copy with what I consider a much nicer cover. Maybe it doesn't look that fancy, kind of plain and on a picture of the Ventures down there, but the U.S. cover is just not a nice cover. It's a picture of a swamp with a doll in it and a tire, and it just looks terrible. So this is that, and the Swamp Rock album. The Swamp Rock came out probably 71. That album in 72, the Ventures came out with New Testament, and I always figured they were trying to take a little attempt to do the heavy guitar sounds that were out with Jimi Hendrix and the. And the Led Zeppelin and Cream, and so they do a Zeppelin song, A Lot of Love, on here, this is a Japanese copy, but with a picture of the Ventures on it that wasn't on the U.S. copy. The U.S. looked similar to this, had a different picture down there. They had this kind of thing. This is more like the U.S. Version, and then that album didn't. They attempted to do that, and it didn't work for them, and so they went into more easy listening styles, figuring that their fan base had grown up and were now family of people, I'm guessing. They figured their marketing, they would try marketing it that, marketing the band that way. This is an album, Shaft, and this is also 1971. That last album was 1971. This one's 71 as well. A Japanese version, and with this another picture of the Ventures on the back here. So that's a again, they went kind of more easy listening on there. Here is their 10th anniversary album, a Japanese copy, and just exactly pretty much like the U.S. copy. I think it has a different gatefold in the middle, a slightly different picture. The Ventures play the Carpenters, and as I say, if a heavy rock guitar wasn't going to work for their, it worked for the Ventures, they were going to go easy listening, and they sure did with this. And so that's the U.S. copy, or maybe it's Canadian artists. Anyway, probably a Canadian copy. And this is the Japanese copy of the same album, and with the Ventures pictured on the cover. Joe Barilli on drums now, and I would probably put this around 1973. Same with this one, Jim Croce's songbook. I don't know that there was ever a Japanese issue of that album, of the of them playing the Jim Croce songs. This is a Japanese copy of an album called Only Hits. The Ventures do not perform on this album, even though it's called a Ventures album. This was a producer's idea. Joe Saraceno, I believe, is the producer on it. And Joe Saraceno. And he hired some session players to do a Ventures album. It's actually a good record, but you know, it's disappointing that they would do it. Try to fake out the audience with that. Okay, here's the Ventures Joy album. Now there's actually Ventures back on this album, and I think Jerry McGee was kind of halfway in and halfway out of the band at this point, and Bob is playing lead on much of this album. It's a great record, actually. I really like it. Ventures play the classics, and a Japanese version. This interesting version from Australia with a different cover. I wanted to just show that. Here is an album that is not anybody's favorite. A few people like songs on it, but I don't think it's anybody's favorite Ventures album. Maybe there's a few. I'm sure, of course, there's always an exception, but for the most part. And this is a Japanese version. In the U.S., it would have said the New Ventures, and of course it's covered up here anyway, but it just says the Ventures here for Japan. They didn't need to a New Ventures. The Ventures were still doing well enough in Japan. And this, again, is another producer's idea, I understand. And, anyway, not a great album. It's disco is what it is. And here's this came in the 80s, but the Ventures doing disco again. This is just a little 45 RPM EP. Here is UA album. Actually, the Ventures had gone to UA earlier than this. I don't know what the first UA album was, but in the US anyway. This in the US would have been the last album that United Artists put out. After the Ventures finished with Liberty, they were on United Artists, or United Artists took them over. And this is a Japanese copy of the Ventures TV themes. It's really a compilation of these albums, or is it? Actually, I don't know. This is not a compilation. These songs were unique to this album, or originally on this album. And there's a picture of the Ventures with Joe Barilli. Let's see. Here's I see a couple of albums I wanted to put in before I got here. This is Rock and Roll Forever, and this was released in 1972. It's another United Artists album for the Ventures, and I'd kind of gotten past that. But the last album was from, you know, probably 77 or so, and 76 or some of those albums. But this one was from 72, and it had Harvey Mandel on lead guitar, and it's just a great, one of the best Ventures albums of them all. It's more of a jam session, and Mel Taylor plays drums, and Larry Taylor, his brother from Canned Heat, plays bass on this album. It's a Japanese issue. You hear Don Wilson shouting a lot, but I don't think he plays any guitar on it. They have a sax player playing on it, a great saxist, and sax player. And I don't believe Bob Bogle. Bob Bogle and Don are pretty much sitting in the mixing room, I think, and producing, quote-unquote, this album. And there's an earlier Japanese issue of it, but it's the same album. Nice back cover there. A live shot of the Ventures. The back cover of the other one is like the U.S. back cover. Here's a series of albums, starting a series of albums from Japan on the East World label, and this one's called 60s Pop, and Whittier Boulevard's on there. I like the version of Whittier Boulevard on here. Now, a little bit slick, some of these versions of the songs, a little bit polished, overproduced, but they're still good. Coming Home, great version. I love Coming Home off of this album. And these were strictly Japanese albums. St. Louis Memory, I don't remember this being too good a record. Oh, it's got some redos of some of their songs. A One-Way Ticket was good on here. I like that one. St. Louis Memory is a vocal and kind of an embarrassing one. Pops in Japan, 81. I think I listened to it once. Tokyo Calling, this was kind of a hard to find one. Either I have it on the CD and the LP. I'm trying to remember which one was harder to get. But anyway, even though it's rare, I don't know that it's that great an album. I'll have to see. I think it has another group of re-recordings on it. I think Yuzuru no Hoshi is on there, which is a great song. This is The Ventures. This came out in 1975, this thing, and it says special DJ copy in the bottom right there. And it was apparently a DJ-only thing, and it's mostly a compilation, but it has a recording. You see a girl down here, her name was Leisha, and she sang Feelings, that when the Ventures were down in Mexico, some of them anyway. They'd heard, I know Don was there, and he'd heard Morris Albert, the Spanish version of Feelings, and written by Morris Albert, and he said, oh, we gotta record that for the U.S. market, an English version. And so they put that on here, or at least, and they tried to, they also made a single out of it, and they thought they'd get the hit with it, but Morris Albert decided, no, I'm going to released it in the U.S. and of course he had the big, huge hit with it. This is a version of More Golden Greats. I don't know why I didn't have it up here earlier, but anyway, this is it, and it's for the Armed Forces Radio. I guess the AFRTS, probably Transcription Service. Yeah, that's exactly what it is. Armed Forces Radio Transcription Service, and it's More Golden Greats. There's nothing, the same. Same versions of the songs that were released on the commercial album, but then the B-side is the Bee Gees, so it's only half the album. There is a more interesting Armed Forces Radio Ventures record that has an interview with Dick Clark, and I had that one. I found it had a skip in it when I bought it, and so I returned it, but I do have, it's a great recording, might find the recording in places on the internet. Supergroup, The Ventures, more super sounds from the original. Oh, well, this is just a compilation. The only reason I have it here, is because the cover was drawn by Dean Torrance of Jan and Dean. I think that's of interest to some folks of early surf music and instrumental. And well, the Jan and Dean, of course, weren't instrumental. Where is it mentioned? Here it is. Dean Torrance did the cover illustration. This was an interesting record I found, apparently this would be something that the Ventures, they did it like, I don't know, two or three times in the 70s, where they'd put out before they came and toured, they'd put out an album people could buy about the, you know, maybe it had some of the songs they were doing in the tour. Probably had quite a few of them, but not the live versions. These would be the studio versions of songs, and many of them they would have performed on that tour. Here's just a series of nice German pressings. The German vinyl is excellent. These are just compilations. I like the cover on this one. The Ventures Best 2. Here's Walk Don't Run Volume 2, a nice German copy of that one, a nice German pressing. Looks like a similar back cover to what was released in the U.S. This one's got some stains on the left side there. This is All About the Ventures. It's just a gatefold version I found. I have the box version, but this is a gatefold. I thought it was interesting. It's not red vinyl or anything. I think it's just black vinyl. This is what Mel went off to do in 1973. He took Jerry with him, and Bob Spalding is in there, and Johnny Durrell, and so Jerry McGee, Johnny Durrell, Bob Spalding, or do I have that? Bill Lincoln, I know, is a player on here. So anyway, he took these guys toured Japan. They made this album Roll Over Beethoven. Yeah, it's kind of hard to find. It's a good record. Ventures Best 20, another compilation. The only reason I have it on here is a nice picture of those amplifiers, the award amplifier that they played. That's the BG-1000. It's a very loud amplifier. It's a transistor amp, but it's a very good amp. I have one myself, and it's quite an amplifier. Oh, I found this at a thrift store, Semi Mosley, who made the Mosrite guitars for the Ventures. And this is a gospel record he did, I found in a thrift store. There he is playing one of his guitars. And I thought that was kind of cool. Not a bad record, actually. It's well produced. And he's got some good playing on it. Anyway. So that's just some, as I said, odds and ends that I hadn't covered in the other videos. Maybe I'll have another one like this in the future.